Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Buddy Hackett.
Well, this is the fifth show I'm doing here today. So when I walk out a little slower than I do earlier. Because when you get to be old like me, you get tired easy. You don't believe that, do you? You're very young and beautiful. Do you know that? Do you like being young and beautiful? Enjoy it now. It don't last. That's one thing I never was. Young and beautiful. I was young and homely. But it didn't affect me too much. I always did good with girls. They see me, they would always wave. Once John Raitt made me a date with the most beautiful girl I ever saw. I was in a show called Lunatics and Lovers, and he was in Pajama Game. And the matinee days, I said to him, John, make me a date with one of those beautiful girls. And he did. And I didn't show up because I felt sorry that she had to go with me. But I'm getting to the time now when I just reflect. I'm going to retire soon. There was a couple guys who were retired in Florida. And their boat name was Sam Cohen. And I say that so you understand the ethnic quality of the story. So one says, he says, what are you doing now you're here in Florida in retirement? What do you do to amusing yourself? He says, I'm a buff on television. I'm watching the television in the daytime, the soapies I watch. And I take walks sometime, a little fish, but mostly the television. Take a nap in the afternoon, in the night. I look the late, sometimes the late, late, what I care, Johnny, come in with all that, and I'm looking. He says, what about you? He says, bees. He says, I don't hear so good. I'm old. Sound to me like you said bees. He says, I said it, bees. That's my hobby, bees. You got a hobby, bees? Yes. You're not afraid to have bees? What, you got ives? I don't got no ives. No, I got them in a house. You got it with you in a house, bees? You are an old man. A bee gives a bite, swells up your nose, blows up, and you die. Gets in your brains. You get craziness. He said, one thing, I got them loose in the house in one room. One room, it's your hobby. You're going into the room, you say, hello, bees. They don't know you. A bee ain't a dog. Bites the nose, swells up, blows your brains out. What are you talking? He said, they in one drawer. In a drawer, you open the drawer, you look in the drawer, you put in a hand to see, they give a bite on your finger. You go, oop, boom, they bite the nose, blows your brains out of your ear. And you're a dead person. He said, they ain't loose in the drawer. He said, they're in a little box. He's a little box. How many you got? He says, 400. He said, 400 in a little box. They'll suffocate. They'll die. He says, the hell with them. It's only a hobby. Be right back to play the game.
Bring your special salad dressing, Grandma Quinn.
Oh, sure, Dad. Couldn't forget my secret recipe. Now, let me get ready, Pastor. I have a confession to make. My real secret is Hidden Valley Ranch. I just mix their secret recipe with mayonnaise and milk, and watch this.
Terrific dressing.
How do you get this special taste?
Pastor, that's a secret.
Hidden Valley Ranch. Nobody else has our secret recipe or our special taste.
Love my RV furniture.
At RV Furniture, the people are so friendly and so helpful.
At RV Furniture, I really felt important.
I bought my sofa, my love seat, my tables, my lamps. And I love it all.
Sales, delivery service, quality, everything from beginning to end is outstanding.
To tell you the truth, it's so well displayed and so they're well known. RB Furniture is so well known.
RB Furniture really spoils their customers.
Yes, sir, folks. Here we are in make-believe land. It's Hollywood. It's glitter, glamour, gulch. And there's a broken heart for every bulb. What does that mean? I don't know what that means. What do you start the day with a day like today, there?
Well, we have to show our audience the secret word.
You show them that.
Buddy, if one of our players says the secret word, the duck will come down and give all of them $100.
I think that duck takes physics, you know that? Every time he drops, something drops with him. Everybody gets $100.
Everybody gets $100.
Are you keeping score?
Yes, sir.
How many contestants have so far received $100 from that duck?
Actually, none, buddy.
That's right, and that's the way we're going to keep it. It's a simple word, find right around the house. Xylophone.
We don't know what it is.
It's a word that's found anywhere. Delicatessen. You don't know what the words.
No, I don't.
They told me one of the words the other day when I was interviewing a man about Frank Sinatra, the secret word was Italian. They thought it would come up.
It didn't.
It didn't come up. No, that's when. Then they said another word. I said one of the words once, but that don't count if I say it. The word is said, you should think it would count, don't you?
Well, it has to be said by one of the contestants.
Yeah, if I was you, I wouldn't have no opinions. Your job is hanging by a thread anyway. That poor man, I don't know why he takes it. You fit the part perfect. You're just wonderful the way you play this part. Are you playing it?
I'm just
that's you.
To you. Yes,
oh,
yes.
That's pitiful. All right, start the game.
Buddy, our first player is really a very nice lady, but nobody wants to meet her. Jerry Uhlenhout, meet Buddy Hackett.
He said, Buddy, our first player is really very nice, but nobody wants to meet her.
That's right.
Nobody wants to meet you?
No.
I'm glad to meet you.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, I like the way you're dressed. You have a nice tan and... Are you married?
No, I'm not.
You're single?
I'm single.
Ever been married?
Never.
Never. You going with anybody?
No, I'm not.
You have a live-in?
No.
Want to rent one? I like to spend the night sometime.
Oh.
Yeah, I just got to get a note for my wife. I'm married to the exotic Shireen Dubois.
Oh, really?
Oh, yes. That was her maiden name.
Oh.
That's why I was in shock when I met her mother, Esther Cohen. Why doesn't people want to meet you?
I hope it's because of my job.
What's your job?
I'm a tax auditor with the Internal Revenue Service.
Oh! You are a tax auditor?
Yes, I am.
So what, people pay their taxes? They shouldn't be afraid.
No, I don't think so either.
Do you ever audit somebody and they don't have to pay more?
All the time. Mm-hmm.
And they don't have to pay more?
1 out of 5.
1 out of 5,
right.
Don't have to pay more?
Mm-hmm. That's right.
You said all the time.
Oh!
20% of the time people don't have to pay.
You're right.
What percentage they usually go up? About, say if they paid 12,000 tax.
Oh,
What's whom?
I don't know. You know, it could be anything. It just depends. So.
You know, the first time I got audited was 1949. When I was a kid, I had a fight with a kid in the neighborhood and I knocked his tooth out. And the first time I walked in to be audited, he's sitting behind a desk. And he says to me, "Remember me?" And I said, "How'd you like to lose another tooth?" I was tough. It cost me quite a bit.
Oh, really?
Yeah. There were some discrepancies. I never knew you're not allowed to deduct a cat.
Oh, really?
Especially you don't own it. What are some of the weird things people deduct?
Oh, my. Let's see.
So what?
Weird things. Oh, I had one that wanted to deduct her goldfish. Take it as an exemption.
Yeah, well, nothing wrong with that.
Oh, well, she thought so, too.
And you didn't let her take off the fish?
No.
So what'd she have to do, get rid of the fish?
No, she just couldn't take it as an exemption.
How much did she want to take off a year for a
goldfish? Well, you know, an exemption is worth about $750.
Oh, that's ridiculous. You can't take off more than $200 for a goldfish.
I think that's what she had to pay back.
What about nowadays with the gasoline costing so high? Are people allowed to take off more for travel and all like that? Or you guys
no
still trying to think it's 20 cents?
Anymore.
What do you mean?
There's not, no.
If there's only one way a person get from their home to their business, can't they take off?
No. That's your personal commute. You can't deduct it.
Well, suppose they don't take the car to work. They can't get there. They can't get paid. You don't get nothing.
That's right, yeah.
But you still, you got your own rule.
No, I don't.
You can't play this game. You're not eligible.
Buddy, it's time to play You Bet Your Life.
Time to play You Bet Your Life. The category is people, and the topic is foreign-born celebrities.
Will I give her the rules, Buddy?
You give her anything you want. She's going to get it anyway.
Buddy's going to show you a list and ask you a question about it. It'll be up to you to put each item in the list in the proper category. Now, the first question is worth $25, and after that, we'll double your money for every time you give us a correct answer. But remember, the object of the game is to end up with more money than the other players. And if you do, you'll be invited back at the end of the show to meet Leonard. There you go.
And anything that you win, you have to declare. Which is a rule that is not applied to any other contestant. Ballet dancer Mikhail Baryshnikov.
Mikhail Baryshnikov. That's right.
Oh, the both of them are here, huh? Was born in Russia. Which of these celebrities were also foreign-born and which were not? Hervé Villechiese. That's Herb Villechiese.
Hervé Villechiese.
Yes.
That's correct. Yes, Jerry, you now have $25.
He was born in France. William Shatner.
No.
That's incorrect, but you still have $25.
He was born in Canada. Oh. Eric Estrada.
Yes.
That's incorrect, but you still have $25,
No,
Jerry.
He was born back east somewhere.
Oh.
Rula Lenska.
Yes.
That's correct. You now have $50.
Paul Anton.
Well, that's, who?
Oh, Robert De Niro. Oh. Robert De Niro.
No.
Robert De Niro.
No.
No.
She said
that's
no.
Correct. You now have $100. And Jerry, you have an option now. There's one item on the list that you haven't seen yet. And here's your option. You can either quit with your $100 and hope it's enough to beat the other players, or if you answer the next question correctly, we'll triple your money. But if you answer it incorrectly, we'll take half your money away. What do you want to do?
I'll go for it.
You're going to go for it.
Anne Margaret.
Yeah.
That's correct. And you wind up with $300. Perhaps that'll be enough to bring you back to meet Leonard.
When you go for a fling on the flume, is he sitting far downstream?
Get close, get closer.
When you book a cozy little table for two, do you find something has come between you?
Get close, get closer.
Only Certs has flavor crystals and resin for great taste and fresh breath that lasts over an hour. When you want a smooch, does she call the pooch?
Get close, get closer.
That dynamite shine on my no-wax floor was starting to fizzle out. Then I got Bright. New Bright. The no-wax floors.
For a beautiful dynamite no-wax shine, nothing shines brighter than Bright.
Bright cleans and shines my no-wax floor the way I want it to shine, without wax. Look, now my dynamite no-wax floor has a dynamite no-wax shine.
For a beautiful dynamite no-wax shine, nothing shines brighter than Bright.
Okay, who will open the bidding? Do I hear a 40? 40, 40.
Kate, I ran out of furniture polish right in the middle of this, Queen Anne.
Take my pledge.
Oh, but I wasn't using pledge.
Well, what's the difference?
Watch.
Pledge brings out the beauty of the wood. Shines better than your polish. See the difference?
My polish looks blurry.
And pledge? Pledge is beautiful.
Now, that's a Queen Anne that even Anne would be proud of.
Pledge brings out the beauty. Every time you dust.
My text got more.
Yep.
My man got more.
Yeah.
My George got more.
Uh-huh. More close shaves per blade.
Super 2 Ultrex gives more close shaves than Track 2. Watch. One push pushes out soap and stubble. Your twin blades start clean, sharp for more close shaves. Ultrex slides on Track 2 razors, clicks on Atra. Get Ultrex for more close shaves.
Hey, more close shaves than Track 2.
Runners up on today's show will receive Corning Plant Helpers. They'll help a lot of your houseplants grow bigger and healthier than in clay or plastic pots. Plant Helpers by Corning. And Ace Hardware's desktop calculator features a bright 13-digit display, rapid printout, an independent 4-key memory, and a compact design from your neighborhood Ace Helpful Hardware Man. And long-lasting Lucite Rustic Stain from DuPont gives you the durability and convenience of latex plus the natural beauty of oil-stained wood. And Nescafe, the world's largest selling brand of instant coffee. Nescafe is available in both regular and green label decaffeinated. And now back to Buddy Hackett and You Bet Your Life.
I don't believe it that they had an IRS agent on here. Wonder, you know, probably Bob Eubanks or the other producer, they probably have a little problem with their tax, and they said, hey, want to be on television? Who you got now?
Buddy, our next player is an expert on Middle Eastern dancing. Marilyn Manzi, meet Buddy Hackett.
Have you got two for a dime? I want to make a call. Marilyn Manzi, you're beautiful.
Thank you.
And you have almost nothing on.
Almost.
You got just a little bib down there. Don't you? Are you going to show us about some dancing?
I sure am.
Please do it for us. Do it. I can't wait.
I need Ron's help.
Ron, go help her. Do whatever
have
she says.
Seat?
Ron, I'll pay you later. Oh, look at that. She's going to vamp Ron. That's what she's going to do. She's gonna vamp Ron. Ron is gonna go crazy. Ron is gonna go nuts. Ron, throw it over here, Ron. Look what's happening to poor Ron. Just look how Ron has gone crazy. This is killing Ron. Ron is gonna die. This is the end of Ron. Poor Ron is finished. It's over for Ron. Oh boy. Now Ron can't take it no more. I don't think Ron's gonna last. It's over for Ron. All right, give us a break, lady. Okay, you've chosen a category. Food and drink. And your topic is popular snacks. Oh, who would know more? Okay. All right, here's your list. I said, here's your list. There you go. According to the National Restaurant Association, nuts are a popular snack. Served in bars. We're 2 minutes over. Which of these snacks are more popular than nuts, and which are less?
Your first question is worth $45, Meryl.
Starting with... pretzels.
More.
That's correct, Marilyn. You now have $25.
Potato chests. Potato chests.
More.
That's incorrect. You still have $25, Marilyn.
Beef jerky.
Less.
That's correct. You now have $50.
Cheese and crackers.
Less.
More.
That's incorrect, but you still have $50, Marilyn.
Pork rinds.
Less.
That's correct. You now have $100, and this is your option. You can quit with your $100, triple it, or lose half it. What do you want to do?
I want to triple it.
Go ahead. Go for it.
Popcorn.
More.
That's incorrect. That means you wind up with $50, Marilyn.
All right.